Disney has an iron fist on dollars at the box office. Our movie man, Erik Childress, joins us on set. Good morning to
Good
you.
Morning.
And how soon before Iron Man 3 crosses that $1 billion mark?
A week, 10 days,
That's
maybe?
Soon.
Yeah, I mean, it's $175 million is the second biggest U.S. opening of all time for
Huge
a three-day
hit.
Weekend, and $700 million worldwide globally right now. It's a monster hit. The summer champion has been crowned.
Good for Disney. Here's
yep.
what else happened over the weekend. Iron Man 3, as we mentioned, at $174 million. Then the numbers just drop off
yep.
from here. Pain and Gain at 7, 42 at 6, Oblivion, well, in Oblivion with
yeah.
$5 million, and The Croods at 4 million. Sad, though, 5 million is still a lot of money.
Yes, it is.
All right, coming up this weekend, The Great Gatsby, highly anticipated,
yeah.
and Tyler Perry also has
mm-hmm.
a new film. Is Gatsby the go-to movie, or will it be Tyler Perry?
Well, I mean, if you're looking at what's going to win this weekend between the two of them, Gatsby is going to do better. But it's a film that Warner Brothers is obviously looking at, you know, very closely because it's a $100 million budget. Some people are trying to project it's going to do $40 million this weekend. I don't think it's going to do that high, maybe in the mid-20s.
And you saw Gatsby.
Yeah, it's not good. It's pointless.
You did not love it.
No.
All right, let's move on to what's coming up this summer. We're taking a look at what the scene will look like for Paramount this summer,
mm-hmm.
and we have Star Trek Into Darkness and World War Z.
Yeah, they only have two films on the docket this summer, and Star Trek Into Darkness, which opens next weekend, very curious. It's gotten some mixed reviews so far from critics, and the studio's doing a very interesting thing, is that they're holding now press screenings from the remaining press until the day it opens, and IMAX screenings next Wednesday.
Is that a big mistake?
It's a big mistake because it puts this sort of aura on the film that maybe they're hiding it for some reason, because they've shown it to a few
Ooh.
People, it's gotten some mixed reviews, so now people are sort of speculating what's wrong with this movie, and Star Trek movies don't do very well overseas. It's not Star Wars, so this film is not going to be a monster hit for Paramount.
You mentioned on the show that people at Warner Brothers are probably going to be sweating it out
mm-hmm.
this summer. What about the folks over at Paramount?
They're very very nervous about World War Z. I mean, this is a film that was supposed to come out last Christmas. They delayed it to reshoot the entire third act of the film. Some people are speculating that the budget has ballooned to like $400 million.
Oh.
That seems a bit high, but even if you cut it down to like $250-$300. This is a film that's going to have to gross over $600 million worldwide. I don't think it's going to do $100 million here in the U.S. So this is the film that people are sort of waiting to be the big bomb of 2013. So Warner Brothers won't have that title with Giant Slayer anymore.
Well, thanks for taking us behind the scenes on that one, Erik.
Thank you.
Have a good weekend.
You're welcome.